Did you know this can of soda has a pH of 2.5? And in a true material science turf war, we're gonna go head to head, metals and ceramics.
At CourseTech, we push our ceramics to their limits, all in the name of making better materials and designs for our customers. I'm Dr. David Hook.
And I'm Dr. Amy Morsey. In this series, we're taking you into the lab to show you how ceramics can withstand even the most extreme conditions. This is a fountain drink dispenser, and inside this you'll find CourseTech ceramic products. They fit about here, and the function is to mix the syrup with the carbonated water to create a tasty soda beverage. Your typical soda has a pH around 2.5, which is highly corrosive to most materials. Today's experiment, we're going to take a metal and ceramic and go head-to-head and see which one corrodes in a soft drink. All right, we're gonna pour the cola into the beaker so we can soak our metal and ceramic. As I'm looking into this right now, I can see some bubbles. So it appears our corrosion test might be working. While we let our two samples sit in the soda, check out what happens when we use hydrochloric acid on metal and ceramic. This acid has a pH of 1, which is significantly stronger than the soda. In about 4 hours, the metal is reduced to remnants, while the ceramic is left unscathed. Let's go check out our soda experiment. All right, let's really dry these off and get a look. So I can definitely see when I'm looking at the surface of the metal that there's pitting on it. That would definitely affect the taste of your drink if it were in the beverage valve of the fountain drink dispenser. And the ceramic looks exactly like it did when I put it in. In general, in a material science turf war, the ceramics are always going to win in the corrosion test. They can hold up much better in highly corrosive environments like sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid. Pretty much anything that you can think of that would corrode, the ceramic is going to outperform the metal. Anybody want some nasty cola?